The assistant enables you to search and explore data by asking questions in natural language. Insights are uncovered by exploring data sources, drilling into data, and creating dashboards using assistant-recommended visualizations. With AI learning, your usage and preferences are used in subsequent recommendations to provide a personalized experience. In this video, you will see how to access the assistant panel, profile and explore data using natural language, add assistant recommended visualizations to a dashboard, and modify dashboard visualizations. Before we start, let's set the context for this video. The scenario is to find products that have not performed well. The assistant will be used to explore the data and identify products that should be reviewed further. The Great Outdoors data module will be used. It contains sales, revenue, and returned item counts. These are the dashboards that will be built by the end of the video. The one on the left will be built by me, and the one on the right will be built by the assistant using advanced analytics and artificial intelligence. The assistant can be launched from dashboards or explorations. This video will use a dashboard. On the home page, select Open Menu, New Dashboard. The blank template will be used, and the Great Outdoors data module will be used as the data source. The assistant panel is opened by clicking the assistant icon. When assistant starts, it begins by asking a question of how it can help. Clicking help shows suggestions for getting started. Before getting started with my analysis, I want to become familiar with my data. View data sources shows me all the supported data sources I have access to in my content and team content. Since I created the dashboard using the Great Outdoors data module as my data source, that's what the assistant has context and focus on currently. Clicking on the Great Outdoors data module, I see a list of measures. Clicking revenue shows me details about the measure, such as how it's aggregated, related fields, and it also tells me that the revenue missed expectations by 4.73%. I'm going to remember that for later, as that seems like a good thing to look at. If I wanted to look at specific details about a column, for example, the product column, I would type show column product. I can see related columns. Assistant also shows other data sources with a column called product. They're not relevant to my analysis, so I will ignore them. Now, before I start my analysis, I'd like to do some data profiling to understand the data better. So, for example, to find out how many products are in my data set, I would type how many products. The summary is presented and I see there's 144 products. Now, to get a sense of my revenue, I can ask a number of questions. So, for example, I'm going to start with asking what the average revenue is. To get the minimum revenue, I type show minimum revenue. And to get the maximum revenue, I type show maximum revenue. Now that I have a better understanding of my data, I'm ready to start my analysis. So I've gone back and typed the help command, and the assistant presents the information. One of the things that has caught my eye is the assistant can suggest questions. I can see at the bottom, did revenue meet planned revenue is one of the suggested questions. Remembering back when I did my data profiling, this was one of the things that caught my eye that I wanted to look at. I can see that difference of 4.73%, and this is for all products across all years. I want to start building my findings, so I'm going to drag the summary onto the canvas. Continuing on, I'm going to click Show Related Visualizations. Assistant will go look at the data and recommend a number of visualizations. I can see these by clicking the icons along the top. I'm going to select the bar and line chart. It shows me revenue and unit price by order close date. I like the visualization, but I want to make some changes. Now that the chart is on my canvas, I can start to edit it. I want to zoom out to the year. And I want to replace unit price with planned revenue. I can see when I expand the chart, there's really not any significant year that has a major contribution to the missed revenue. I decide that I should drill into the data by looking at it by product. Notice that as I start to type my question, Assistant uses type ahead to make suggestions. Clicking the table icon, I can see the planned and revenue values. I'm going to drag the table out onto the canvas as well. To understand my variance, I'm going to add a calculation. Using the revenue field as my seed, so I want to note two things here. The calculation has been added to the dashboard. It has not been added to the data module. And the assistant changed the visualization to the bubble chart because it was the better visualization to use for the data. Expanding it to get a better view, I can see the leftmost bubble is the Course Pro Putter with the largest revenue variance. Selecting Course Pro Putter in the bubble chart applies a filter to all my visualizations, and I can see that there is significant underperformance year over year. Now that I know which product has the poorest performance, I want to check if it's the result of a high return rate. To investigate if return rate is a major factor, I type compare quantity and return quantity by year, where product equals Course Pro Putter. A line chart is generated showing there's really not been any significant return activity year over year, which makes me think returns are not a contributing factor. I drag this onto my dashboard as well. I can save my dashboard for when I discuss my findings with the Gulf products team. So far in this video, I've decided what my next steps would be. I could have let Assistant drive my investigation after asking my first question, compare planned revenue and revenue by product. When I click Create Dashboard from Chart, the Assistant creates a three-tab dashboard with multiple advanced analytics. If I knew Course Pro Putter had the poorest performance, I could add it as a filter to my revenue tab. Now I'm only seeing the results for the particular product. Looking at the drivers with the highest predictive strengths, I can use this information as guidance on where to proceed next with my analysis. Keep these best practices and tips in mind when working with the assistant. Use the Shift and Up arrow key to retrieve questions. Use natural language for the best results. The assistant attempts to understand questions based on the context of the entire sentence, grammar, punctuation, and spelling. The assistant understands most synonymous terms and phrases. For example, asking for the top three products and three best products gives the same result. Expression-based filters can be used. For example, in, with, top 10 percentage, top or bottom, and greater or less than. Generally, the assistant applies filters before any aggregation is applied to the data. Aggregations and filters can be combined. For example, show revenue in 2010 and 2012 for Boston and Calgary. In this video, you saw how to access the assistant panel, profile and explore data using natural language, and use visualizations that the assistant recommended. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.